A very warm good morning to you all, my dear students of class 9. Yesterday we started the solution of exercise 2.5 up to the question number 7. Today I'll pick one or two portions of each question and try to finish the whole exercise in this lecture. So come to your question number 8. Factorize each of the following. 8a cube plus b cube, 8a cube plus b cube plus 12a square b plus 12a square b plus 6ab square plus 6ab square. We have to factorize this question. It may be written as 2a cube plus b cube plus 12a square b plus 6ab square. What we have, my dear students? We have a cube plus b cube. And in the formula, what is the next term? 3ab a plus b. So see whether any term is common. 2a to the power 3. What is common here? 6ab. If 6ab is common, then we have 2a plus b. What is this? A plus b. A cube plus b cube, a plus b. This term will be equals to 3ab. If it is equals to 3ab, then we can use the formula. So 2a cube plus b cube plus 3 into 2a into b. 3 to the 6ab. Now compare this one. A cube plus b cube plus 3ab into a plus b. And that is equals to a plus b whole cube. Which formula is used here? A cube plus b cube plus 3ab a plus b is equals to a plus b whole cube. Therefore, 2a cube plus b cube plus 3 into 2a into b under bracket 2a plus b is equals to a plus b whole cube. It means 2a plus b whole cube. Only now 4 parts are left. So I will do for you the last portion, which is 5th part of question number 8. And the question is 27p to the power 3, 27p to the power 3 minus 1 upon 216 minus 9 upon 2p square minus 9 upon 2p square plus 1 upon 4p plus 1 upon 4p. Don't worry, after seeing the question, just try to solve it stepwise. 27 may be written as cube of 3. So 3 cube, p cube. Minus 1 is written as 1 cube. 216 is the cube of 6. And write the other two terms as it is given in the question. So what is this? This is the cube of 3p minus cube of 1 upon 6. We have a cube minus b cube. What is in the next term? Minus 3ab minus 3. What is a? 3b. And what is b? 1 upon 6. Minus 3 into a into b and in the bracket a minus b. In the bracket a minus b. 3b minus 1 upon 6. See whether these two terms are equal to this or not. If these two terms are equal to this, we are implement the direct formula. So 3p to the power 3 minus 1 upon 6 to the power 3. This 6 is cancelled with 3. We have minus 3p upon 2 under bracket 3p minus 1 upon 6. Now multiply the bracket. Minus into plus. Minus 3 3 is 9. 9 upon 2 p square minus into minus plus 3 upon 2 into 1.6 6 is cancelled with 3 we have 2 and 2 to your 4 plus p upon 4 plus p upon 4 so that will equals to a minus b whole cube what is a 3p what is b 1 upon 6 a minus b whole cube which formula is used here a cube minus b cube minus 3a square b plus 3ab square is equals to a minus b to the power 3. This is the formula used in the question. So among the 5 questions, 2 is solved for you, remaining 3 is your homework. Now to the question number 9. What is your question 9? Verify x square plus y square equals to x plus y. Verify x square plus y square. Sorry, x cube plus y cube. X cube plus y cube equals to x plus y, x square minus xy plus y square. Here is the is equal to given, is equal to is given here. So this side is known as right hand side and this side is known as left hand side. You take the LHS of the given expression. What is the LHS? LHS equals to x plus y, x square minus xy plus y square. Two terms in the first bracket and three terms in the second bracket. So the first term of first bracket is multiplied to the whole bracket. What is the first term of first bracket? X. X is multiplied to the whole bracket. The whole second bracket is this. Repeat the process again. The next term is with the sign plus y. Plus y is also multiplied to the whole bracket. Now it is simple multiplication. X into x square, x to the power 3, minus x into x, x square, y, plus x into y square, x, y square, plus y into x square, always write in the ascending order of alphabets. So, x square y minus x y square and plus y. See, where are the right terms? Identify the right terms. X square y and x square y. And one more right term is here. X y square and x y square. Minus x square y and plus x square y becomes 0. They are not cancelled. Keep in your mind, they are not cancelled. Minus x square y and plus x square y equals 0. Similarly, xy square minus xy square becomes 0. So what is left to be? X cube plus y cube, which is our right hand side. Hence, this is verified. Very simple method. Take one side, either of the equals to, and go through with the solution. If you are getting the other side of equals to, then the equation or formula is verified. One more part of question you solve by yourself. Come to the question number 3. Factorize the following. 27y2 plus 125z3. 27y2. Question number 10. Second part. Now this time I take the second part of question number 10. 64m to the power 3 minus 343n to the power 3. We have to factorize this expression, and this expression is a cubic expression. 64 is the cube of 4, 343 is the cube of 7. So we can write it 4n to the power 3 minus 7n to the power 3. You know the formula. What is the formula? Since a cube minus b cube is equals to a minus b in another bracket a square plus ab plus b square. This is the formula which you have to use in this question. Therefore, 4n to the power 3 minus 7n to the power 3. What comes at the place of a? Watch it carefully. 4n comes at the place of a and 7n comes at the place of b. Put the value of a equals to 4n and the value of b equals to 7n in this right hand side of the formula. What you will get? A minus b, 4n minus 7n, square of a, square of 4n, square of 4, 16n square, plus a into b, 4n into 7n, 4 7 is 28mn, plus 28mn plus b square, 7n square, square of 7, 49, n square, bracket close. This is the factorization of given expression. Question number 10 is completed. Now it's the time to see question number 11. Factorize. Here we have to use another formula. So I need the more space on the board. Please, you copy the sum in your register. Question number 11. Factorize. What we have to factorize? We have to factorize 27 x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 9xyz. It may be written as 3x to the power 3 plus y to the power 3 plus z to the power 3 minus 3 into ABC. 3x into y into z. 3x, y, z. Compare it. 3 theta, 9x, y, z. Now use the formula. Since a cube plus b cube plus c cube minus 3abc is equals to a plus b plus c, a square plus b square plus c square minus ab minus bc minus c. This is the formula which we have to use in the factorization of given question. Now compare the equation made by us to the formula. What is at the place of x? 3x. What is at the place of a? 3x. At the place of b? y. At the place of c? z. Substitute this value and you will get your answer. Therefore, 3x to the power 3 plus y to the power 3 plus z to the power 3 minus 9xyz is equals to a 3x, b y, c z plus square of a 9x square plus y square plus z square minus a b 3x into y 3xy minus b c minus b c y z minus y z minus a c a z into 3x minus 3x z. That is the answer of question number 11. So this is the whole play of the formula. If you remember the formula, then there will be no problem in the solution of any question. Question number 12 is also same. You have to verify. Question number 13 is same. See the 13 one. I left the question number 12 for you. Question number 13. If x plus y plus z equals to 0, if x plus y plus z equals to 0, then so that x cube plus y cube plus z cube, then so that x cube plus y cube plus z cube is equals to 3xyz. See the question for question number 13. Yes, it is correct. From where we start this solution? What is the formula for x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz? That is equals to a plus b plus c. The formula found by me in the just previous solution, and in the next bracket a square plus b square plus c square minus ab minus bc minus c. But what is given? It is given that x plus y plus z equals to 0. So what we have to put here? X plus y plus z equals to 0. It is given. So 0 multiplied by x square plus y square plus z square minus xy minus yz minus zx. 1 into 0, 0. 2 into 0, 0. 0 into 100, 0. 0 into 374, that is also equals to 0. So if we multiply any number with the digit 0, the product will be always 0. So 0 into this bracket, that is 0. What is the right hand side? X cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz. So x cube plus y cube plus z cube equals to, then minus 3xyz goes to the either side of equals to, it is 3xyz. Hence proof that we have to show, and we get all result, you may write here. Hence proof, if a plus b plus c equals to 0, then always a cube plus b cube plus c cube is equals to 3abc. Few more questions are left, only 3. So we will solve today those 3 questions also. So not only one question is left. Question 14 is same. Since x plus y plus z equals to 0, therefore a cube plus b cube plus c cube equals to 3abc. One of them is, solution was given yesterday, one of them. So only one question is left. Give possible expression for the length and breadth of each of the following rectangle in which the areas are given. Areas are given. Question number first part of the 15. What is the area? Area equals to 25a square, 25a square minus 35a plus 12. And the same given is rectangle. How many dimensions a rectangle has? 2. Length and breadth. So what is the area? This is the area of rectangle. Factorize it. 12 into 25. 250. Find the factor of 300. 25 into 12, 300. A into C is equals to 25 into 12, which is equals to 300. Now write all the factors of 300. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, not 9, not 10, 12, 15, 20, 25, 30, and so on. Write all the factors from 300 and pick only two of them such that their product is equal to 300 and their sum is minus 35. Because B is negative and A and C is positive, therefore both the factors are negative. Choose two factors.
Yes.
20 and 15. 20 into 15, 300, and 20 plus 15, 35. Split the middle term. 25a square minus 20a minus 15a plus 12. 5a is common in first two terms, so we have 5a minus 4, and minus 3 is common in last two terms, again we have 5a minus 4, so 5a minus 4 into 5a minus 3. What is this? This is the product of two numbers, and we all know that area of rectangle is equals to L into B, where length and breadth are the dimensions of rectangle. So what are the dimensions? Therefore, dimensions of the rectangular plot. Dimensions of the rectangular plot are, either you write first this or first this, it doesn't matter, are 5a minus 4 and 5a minus 3. That is your answer. One part in question number 15 is left. You solve by yourself. The last question of the exercise. Here, volume is given, and you all know that volume is of three-dimensional figure, and three-dimensional figure has three dimensions: length, breadth, and height. As we find here, length and breadth. In the next question, we have to find length, breadth, and height. What are the possible expressions for the dimensions of the cuboid? The same is cuboid. Volume of cuboid is given. Volume of cuboid. What is the volume of cuboid? You all know that L into B into H. And the volume of cuboid is given 3x square minus 12x. 3x square minus 12x. So it will also equal to L into B into H. These are the three dimensions of a cuboid. L. LH, and you can see that this one is B. These are the three dimensions of the cuboid. See the common portion. Only you take 3 as a common. If you take 3x as a common, we have x minus 4 is equal to L into B into H. It is 2 over square. 3x equals to 3 into x minus 4 is equal to L into B into H. On comparing both the sides, what will we get? L equals to 3, B equals to x, and H equals to x minus 4 unit. If it is in meter, then meter cube, then volume is in meter cube, then all these units are in meter. If its volume is centimeter cube, then all its units are in centimeter. So all the three dimensions of cuboid are fine. 3, x and x minus 4. So whole chapter is over. Now you have 2 days to revise chapter 1 and 2, because from Monday onwards we will start with chapter number 3, coordinate geometry. Till then, enjoy the study. See you.